Match game, production number 79-01-1. 30-second promo, take one.
Listen, I want to tell you who we got this week. We've got Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Fanny Flagg, and...
Yes, Bob Graham.
And my gorgeous friend, Ava Gabor.
And the very handsome William Daly.
And we'll all be here on Match Game. Tune in, yeah.
I'm not sure about that.
One, and it's take one. Get ready to match the stars. From Vegas, Bart Braverman, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Ava Gabor, Bill Daly, and Fanny Flagg. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now, here's the star of Match Game, Gene Rayburn.
Yeah. Hello there. Thanks very much. Thank you for joining us here on Match Game. You're going to have a wonderful time. Because, as George Bernard Shaw said, over on my left, we have the open-air lunatic asylum. Hello there.
Hello.
George Bernard Shaw said that.
He said that. About you, specifically. If you're all ready, we'll have a go at it.
Good.
By welcoming our two players over here, Patty Olson and Rose Welch. Thank you. We welcome both of you. I want to point out that each of you will be playing two games here, and we'll find out a little bit about each of you before we begin. We're a friendly bunch. We want to get acquainted. Rose, what do you want to tell us about you?
Well, I'm married. I have two children and one husband. I just recently moved from the Bay Area to San Diego, and I'm in the midst of fixing up our house and everything, so I'm just...
A lot of work, isn't it?
Yes.
All right. I hope it goes well for you, and good luck to you here. Rose, Patty, what about you?
Hi, I'm married, and I have a little girl, 2.5, and one due in January, and I love to golf.
Really?
Stand up.
Let's see.
Stand up.
Look it.
One due in January.
Yes, it doesn't show.
Not at all. How do you know?
It's a very small baby. It's a very...
Wait a minute. Stand up, Brad. She's February. It's February. It's amazing. But
what did I tell you about the open-air lunatic asylum? Was I right? Okay, good luck to both of you. Here we go. We'll ask Rose to make her selection first here about A or B.
B, please.
B it is for Rose Welch. The zookeeper said, "Ugly Edna is so ugly." Hey, you're all right there. Today, when she walked through the zoo, I thought a blank had escaped. I'll help you spell it if you want.
Okay, yeah.
But don't say it so loud because people have ears, you know.
We're, what?
We're all not.
Oh, okay. Just put that down there.
I don't hear it at all.
I got to learn how to spell.
Why is so ugly? Animals are so beautiful.
You don't know how either, do you? We don't know how to spell cat. Cat is my answer. C-A-T.
I'll
forget. I'll get an easy
one. That was nothing, Bill, for the love of heaven.
Get the other thing. I'll get it.
Try that.
All right, I don't know.
Dear me. Rose, are you ready?
Yes.
We're ready for you. The zookeeper said, "Ugly Edna is so ugly."
How ugly is she?
I thought we auditioned you earlier. Ugly Edna is so ugly. Like today when she walked through the zoo, I thought a blank had escaped.
A gorilla.
A gorilla.
I think this is a match. I said monkey, ape. So ape
monkey,
is a gorilla.
Monkey, ape is a gorilla. Yes,
match.
Indeed. Yeah. Okay, there it is. What do you got up there?
Hello, sweetheart.
Hello,
you
darling.
Look very nice. Let me put my glasses up. Oh, it's Chex. It's adorable.
Yes, I love this outfit.
Yes.
Thank you, Dayton Anderson.
And the brand is good for your diet.
Very good.
Now, this may look like it says orange and tang, but it doesn't. It
orangutan.
Says orangutan. Now, isn't that
that's a gorilla.
Member of
that's
the
a gorilla.
Gorilla
yeah. Yes. Okay.
What do you say?
Continuing, as will several others after me, with misspelling of the word orangutan, I move right on.
You know.
Can you spell it? Can you spell it? Spell it right now.
O-R-A-N-G-U-T-A-N.
Orangutan.
I was right.
Ten.
Okay.
Gotcha.
What do you got, Miss Ava, honey?
I am so brilliant, I can't stand it. I said gorilla.
Gorilla. Or the rose.
How do you like that? On the nose.
If you could read your writing, I got orangutan.
No way.
Orangutan.
Now, isn't that? That's correct.
You know, it stumped me there for a second. It is a word you have to think about before you spell it. But spelling doesn't count here, Fanny. You can draw a picture.
That's for sure, or I wouldn't be here.
That's true. What have you got there?
Well, I wanted to say gorilla, but I may have spelled the name of a social disease. But I think I'm pretty close.
Close enough.
Ooh.
Well, look at her, Patty.
Boy, that's pretty tough.
Yes, she's got her six already, right off the bat here.
Rodney Rich is really rich. Yeah. Oh,
rich.
Who asked you?
Who asked you?
Rodney Rich is the only man in the world who keeps his waterbed filled with blank.
Mm.
That's how rich he is.
I don't know how to spell it, but I know.
Here we go, Patty. Rodney Rich is really rich. He's the only man in the world who keeps
his... Wait a second.
Mr. Wright over here.
Oh.
This is Mr. Wright.
Yeah. Only man in the world who keeps his waterbed filled with...
Champagne.
Champagne seems like a good answer. They like it out there. Champagne.
A bit of the bubbly, my dear.
Oh, yes, of course. Champagne.
That's one for Patty.
Certainly. Now, here's two for Patty. Your Dom Perignon Champagne, a vintage year.
Wonderful.
Certainly.
I was going to make a joke and say something else.
Yeah?
Gas. You know what I mean?
Yeah. But you didn't.
I didn't say that. Well, just a moment.
That wasn't his answer.
He will not be here for the Christmas party.
You want us
that
to
was
do
not in
Christmas
my slot.
Yet.
But I know that the object is to match, so
very
it's
good. Okay.
Time to get my joke in. A la Nipsey Russell.
You know, once in Europe, I had a bus in it. That's supposed
a what?
To be there. A bus. Thanks for translating, darling. I had it on a champagne. Very fancy.
Champagne. Oh, yes, of course.
That's
a Hungarian.
Right?
Hungarian spelling.
But I can't
get
over it. How clever I am so far.
Two out of two. It's a new record for you.
Unheard of. I always miss.
Okay, Bill. Speaking of misses,
this is not only spell wrong, but it is wrong. I said Perrier water. I didn't Perrier.
Perrier.
Some guy got a hand for Perrier. Can you believe
that? That's
your mother right there.
Okay.
Thanks, Mom.
Fanny, what do you say there?
Champagne.
Oh, I'm the only one, huh? Yes.
Well, it's a tight game. 6-5 is the score. We'll carry on with you in a moment or so. Right now, we have this for you. Here we go. Now, since Rose has matched all of the stars, Patty, you have a shot at matching it here. You can have a choice of A or B.
B, please.
B. Okay, here we go. Ready, Bill?
Ready. Oh, I'm ready. Oh, I'm over ready. I've got the answer already. Let me put that in.
I haven't answered the question yet.
Doorknobs is the one. Oh, yeah.
Doorknobs.
Oh, that was so fast.
It's just for your ears.
Okay.
Ralph said... I have a terrible fear of closed spaces because when I was a baby, instead of a crib, my parents kept me in a blank. Ralph said I have a terrible fear of closed spaces because when I was a baby, instead of a crib, my parents kept me in a blank. Hold on, Patty.
Now, you're not going to believe this. He's taking advice from Ava.
All right. Now, Patty.
Got a lot of wrong ones here.
This, you must match him to stay in the game and achieve a tie. That's the best you could do. I have a terrible fear of closed spaces because when I was a baby, instead of a crib, my parents kept me in a...
dresser drawer.
A drawer. Dresser drawer, she said. Now, she needs a match with you desperately to stay in the game and achieve a tie.
Here's some I threw away. She keeps me in the dark. That wasn't very funny.
Right.
So I put keeps me in a drawer. That's very good.
Drawer! Tie game! Okay. Now, when we have a tie like this, we just turn the lights off here, push the button, reveal one tie-breaking question for each of you. The one who scored the most will be the winner. And Rose, you have a choice of A or B.
A, please.
A it is. A was good to you last time. Let's see what it does for you this time. Dumb Dora's really dumb. She thinks the happy hooker is someone who enjoys blanking. That's how dumb she is. Dumb Dora's really dumb. She thinks the happy hooker is someone who enjoys blanking.
I think it would be easier.
Okay, put that right in the slot there.
I don't like it too much.
That's all right. Okay, Rose, Dumb Dora is really dumb, Rose. She thinks the happy hooker is someone who enjoys blanking.
Fishing?
Fishing, that's one possibility. There are a couple, two or three good chances here. She came up with one of them.
I was going to say crocheting. You know, my ex-wife used to crochet a lot.
Crocheting.
But I said fishing.
Fishing. Oh. Okay, Rose, you got one. Rose is fishing, Brett.
Not me, hon.
No?
No, I don't believe you know how I feel about sports, baseball,
oh, yeah.
Football, fishing,
all that stuff.
Yeah. There's only one I'm interested in.
What's that?
I can't tell you.
Oh.
Making rugs.
Yeah. Making rugs. Yeah, you hook a rug, right?
That's a wonderful
answer. It's a good answer.
Yes.
It's a wonderful answer. You hook
it's a good
rug.
Answer. Right. Okay.
What we learned at camp, Jane.
What did you learn at camp, Charles?
We had a wonderful woman help us. Rug making.
Rug making. Certainly
well,
came
don't
in.
Look at my hair when you say that. Hi. And Ava Gabor has a wig company, so be careful down there, too.
Okay. Is this a wig?
No, no, don't pull it off.
Oh, all right.
No, we can go to the Price is Right like that. We don't need
I was very stupid on this one.
She thinks the happy hooker is someone who enjoys fishing. What do you say?
Stupidly, I said dancing.
Dancing.
Oh, I know it's wrong.
Now, wait a minute. I don't even understand.
No, do I? I told you it wasn't any good.
Okay, Bill? We'll understand yours, won't we?
Fishing?
Fishing!
Hey,
that's good.
Thank you.
You ought to do. He's getting very
make up for the Perrier water.
So
I got to.
That's right.
I got to make up for
okay,
that.
Okay, Miss Fanny, honey.
Sorry, I said making rugs.
Making
sorry.
Rugs. Yeah. All right. So, Rose, you picked up two, and now, Patty, you need two to tie again or three to win. Roy Rogers treats his car just like he treats his horses. Today, after his car wouldn't start, he blanked it. Come on, man. Get away from the microphone if you want to ask a question.
He blanked. Careful, they can see
that's
your
right.
Hook isn't fastened, David.
Shall I fasten that
for
you?
No, no, it's good time.
Oh, it is.
Oh, yeah.
Size 60. Is Roger still with us?
Yeah. He's
riding
still on this planet Earth.
He likes his horse very much. He likes his horse.
Trigger is no
which
longer
one? Is he the guy that likes his horse? He likes his horse.
Oh, yes.
He stopped him.
Right.
He did. I mean, after he died.
Yeah. Actually, you on the right an answer,
you
Bill?
You know what they sound like?
While we're waiting. Yes, of course. You know who Roy Rogers is, don't you? He treats his car just like he treats his horses. Today, after his car wouldn't start, he blanked it. Hold on just a second. No, now you can go.
He kicked it.
He kicked it. Okay.
Who's moaning in the audience?
Who is moaning in the audience?
I don't know.
One of the producers.
He's got an obscene moan call.
Yeah.
I'm gonna...
Got it.
Hey, you know, kicked it.
Kicked it. There's one for Patty.
How much is it?
Okay. These game shows, boy. I'm telling you.
I think that's a wonderful answer, don't you?
I do too.
That's
yeah.
That's a good shot. Now we never had that shot. See, I constantly, as a director, have to watch these things.
Do you mind? I'm talking.
What was that shot?
It's a three shot.
Oh, a three shot. Yeah, that's a one shot. Yeah. Now there's a good shot. Oh, that is a good shot. Yeah. Right. Oh, there's a terrific shot.
Well, he really knows how to get it.
In fact, I don't really care anymore.
Okay, Brett, show him
the
tell.
Shot of rug making.
Why is Charles wearing dark glasses, or we better not ask? Are we better off
he's
not
all right.
knowing?
Yeah.
Sure, he's all right. Yeah. Kick!
That's two for Harry. Four is now Charlie.
I hope this is a match. I really do. He sat on the hood and spurred it while Dale made chicken salad sandwiches on the range.
No,
that was not a match.
That's a match. He's
spurred.
Spurring
is the
verb. The verb is spurred, and that's a match.
Well, but spurring and kicking a horse are two different things. You
oh,
can
really?
Kick a horse without having spurs
that's
on your
feet.
That's right. Okay.
Well, it kicked it.
Kick!
Kick
all right,
kick,
well, put it again. What do you have, Bill?
Saddle it.
Saddle it. Spurred it. Okay. Now, here's the way it is. Patty, you'll come down here if you would, please. You are the winner. And we're going to say goodbye to Rose Welch only temporarily because you'll be back a little bit later to play your second game right after we play the super match with Patty. Okay? See you later, Rose. Right now, we've got a message for you. And hurry back for the super match. Here we go with Patty Olson. She's won the game, and now we'll see how much more money she'll win in the big money super match here. We polled a studio audience not too long ago, Patty, and we said, write down your best answer to this. I think I'm blank. Studio audience is laughing because Patty told us at the beginning of the show in the interview that she's due in January. January. Okay. Anyway, if you match the answer that that studio audience gave us, most often you get $500. For matching their second most popular answer, $250. And for matching the third, $100. Three of our six stars will offer some assistance.
Brett?
I think I'm pregnant.
There's one. You wish.
Bart?
I think I'm in love.
I think I'm in love.
Fanny?
I think I'm sick.
I think I'm sick. All right, the first and third go hand in hand, don't they? I think I'm pregnant, I think I'm in love, and I think I'm sick. You can give us your own answer or choose one of those. What is your pleasure?
I think I'm pregnant.
Let us go.
Okay. I'll go along with that. You say so. Bring the rabbit in. No, here we go. She says, I think I'm pregnant. Let's go down to the bottom and reveal a $100 number. I think I'm pregnant. You got it right off the bat. It's the low one. You got to be up a little higher than that, didn't you?
Yeah.
I think I'm going out of my head.
I think you're going,
going out of my mind.
Yeah, that was a song. Let's see if it's up there under the $250 number. I think I'm in love. All right. Last one is, what do you say, audience?
Crazy.
Okay, slide it.
I think I'm crazy.
Crazy, you're right. Did you think of that? All right, listen, you got $100, means at least you'll play for us 10 times that amount, or $1,000. However, we want you to spin the wheel and see if you can double your money and play for $2,000. Good luck to you. Give it a hefty spin. Here we go.
Go, baby.
Bing. Let's see if she gets a double. Double, but you're playing with a good player, Fanny Flagg, there for $1,000. Face me if you would, please, and good luck to you. This is it. Sunset blank. Sunset blank. Okay, Patty, if you give us the answer that Fanny has on that card, we give you $1,000. What do you say to that?
Sunset Boulevard. Yeah!
Sunset Boulevard. All right. Let's find out from Fanny right now what her answer is. She says Sunset Boulevard will match you for the $1,000.
Do you remember the song Sunset, Sunrise?
Yadam,
yadam. I hated that song, so I wrote Boulevard.
Aha! Congratulations to you. Patty Olson.
$500 all together. Congratulations to you. Now, we want to bring Rose Welch back here. Rose, here comes Rose Welch back to play the second and final game. And you can get up there if you would, please. Now, here we go. Rose, we're going to ask you once again to choose A or B.
A, please.
A it is? All right. The funeral director said the deceased must have owned an Italian restaurant. Instead of flowers, his relatives are dropping blanks into his grave.
Dropping blanks.
The deceased must have owned an Italian restaurant.
Oh, that's sweet.
Isn't it?
Flowers.
Instead of flowers.
Oh, wait. I like it.
Okay.
Do you ever have the feeling that he's nodded off when he reads it?
Right.
Very American.
Hi, folks. I'm fine.
Ready, Charles? Here we go. The funeral director said the deceased must have owned an Italian restaurant. Instead of flowers, his relatives are dropping blanks into his grave.
Meatballs?
Meatballs! Yeah. Meatballs, that ain't bad.
Oh, meatballs.
Yeah, anything Italian. Lasagna, anything. What do you got there, Bart?
Close enough for government work, I guess. Yes. I said pepperonis, actually.
Pepperonis! So. Okay, that's another good one. What do you got there?
So hateful with that bloody buzzer. Brrr.
Yeah, couldn't they so be a it's little louder kind? And just harsher than usual.
Just a zit is all yeah. we need. Just and some meatballs and spaghetti with a red sauce.
Meatballs, spaghetti, red sauce? Oh, yeah, that's one for her.
What I had earlier today in San Diego at 1 a.m. at Philippi's restaurant on Indio. Meatballs.
Meatballs.
Another free meal.
Okay, but what do you say to this? Instead of flowers, relatives dropping blanks into his grave.
I said spaghetti.
Spaghetti. Ross, you got two so far,
pasta,
Bill.
Pasta, one boo for
pasta.
Me.
Pasta. No, that's Italian. What
meatballs.
Do you got? Meatballs. Okay, that's three. You stand by. Right now, we've got a message for America. Listen, it's time to say goodbye. Say goodbye.
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 Goodbye. Goodbye. Goodbye. Goodbye. Goodbye. Today's consolation prizes are a 16-inch silver-plated shrimp shell dish from Taylor Rental Centers. Taylor rents practically everything. When you want it, rent and save at Taylor. And a Fabergé collection featuring organic shampoo and conditioner, both with pure wheat germ and honey for fresh-smelling hair with Super Shine Super Body Organics by Fabergé. And polyglycol protection for your car. Heat-actuated formula that penetrates, protects. Polyglycol won't let Mother Nature rip you off. Available at new car dealers everywhere. And Bissell's new broom picks up dirt and litter, nails and crayons from carpets to bare floors, corner brushes, clean to baseboards, Bissell's new broom. And from Hawaiian Tropic comes an attractive beach mat and Hawaiian Tropic natural tanning lotions and oils, Hawaiian Tropic, the tan of the islands. And a grill, and Eskimo Pie. Dairy fresh vanilla ice cream covered with special chocolate flavored coating, Eskimo Pie, refreshing and delicious anytime for an old plush treat. And from Fesco, the patented no hands can, the top flips up with the push of a pedal and 6 month supply of lemon scented liners, all from Fesco. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game, a Mark Goodson, Bill Chapman production. This program was edited for broadcast.